This video tutorial I will explain how to use Java persistent query language, and it is also called Jpql. Jpql is platform independent. Today in your project you are using MySQL database, and after 3 months you want to change it to Oracle database. In that case you no need to do any code change if you are using Jpql. You no need to rewrite the query which you have written using Jpql. The same code will work in both MySQL database and Oracle database. Here you can see user entity class which implements a serializable interface, and this user entity class is mapped to users table, and it has properties like ID, user ID, first name, last name, etc. And each of these properties are mapped to users table columns. When we write a Jpql query, we use entity class name and its properties. We won't use column names and table names. In this case, we are selecting first name and last name, which are the properties of user entity class. And from user entity class and alias name, we have given as user, where user.userid, then parameter value. Next, we will see some of the sample program. Now we will see how to write a select SQL query using Jpql. In user repository interface, I have defined the find user entity by user ID method. And this method accept user ID. And in param annotation, I have given name as user ID. And this method returns user entity object. And in this method, I have applied query annotation. And here I have written the query using Jpql. Select user from user entity. Alias of user entity I have given as user. That is what I am using here. And where condition user dot user ID. User ID is the property of user entity class. Equal to named parameter name, that is user ID, that should match to this one. To test this method, here I have written JUnit test method in user repository test. The name of the method is test find user entity by user ID. Here I have defined the user ID. Then I am calling find user entity by user ID method of user repository object, and passing the user ID. This method returns user entity object. That I am asserting it should not be null. And also the user ID of user entity object should equal to whatever user ID we are passing. And before run this method, this setup method will be run. And in the setup method, I am creating 3 users. And one of the users' user ID is this one. Before run this JUnit test case, empty the database. Now I am going to run this JUnit test case in debug mode. Select this method. Here we got unsatisfied dependency exception. We will see how to correct it. Here we have to use table annotation. Remove this. Empty the database. And here you can see the JUnit test case has been passed. Now we will see how to write a query to select specific fields using Jpql. Here I have defined a method getFullNameByUserID, and it accepts UserID as the parameter, and this method returns a list of object array. And in this method I have applied a query annotation, and I am using the query select user.firstname comma user.lastname from user entity class, and alias name I have given as user, where user.userid equal to named parameter, and this name should equal to param annotation whatever name we have given. And in this query, first name, last name and user id are properties of user entity class. And here you can see the user entity class, and here you can see user id, first name and last name. To test this method, here I have defined the method. The JUnit method name is test get full name by user id. Here I am calling get full name by user id method of user repository object, and passing the user id, and this method returns object array list that I am asserting it should not be null. Using a for each loop, I am getting object array, and from object array I am getting first name and last name, then asserting it should not be null, and also I am displaying the first name and last name. Before run this JUnit test method, empty the database. Select the JUnit test method. Now I am running this JUnit test method in debug mode. And here you can see the JUnit test case has been passed. With this user ID, this record is there. First name is Roy, last name is P. That is what we got here. Now we will see how to write update SQL query using JPQL. Here I have defined the method update user email verification token, and here I am passing a token and email ID. In this method I have applied a query annotation, and the query is update user entity, alias of user entity I have given as user, set user dot email verification token, that is a property of user entity class, equal to named parameter token and email ID. And also in this method I have applied modifying annotation and transactional annotation, because we are updating the user details. To test this method, here I have defined the JUnit test method. The method name is test update user email verification token. Here I have defined the token, then I am calling update email verification token method of user repository object, and passing the token and the email ID. Based on this email ID, the particular user token will be updated. Then I am calling find by email method of user repository object, passing email ID. This method returns user entity object, and here I am asserting the email verification token of user entity object should equal to the token which we have passed. And if it is true, then the JUnit test case will be passed. Before run JUnit test case, empty the database. Select the JUnit test case. Run as JUnit test. Here you can see the JUnit test case has been passed. Click on refresh. And here you can see for this particular user email token is updated. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.